In part one of this video, we looked at precipitation reactions. These reactions involve solubility, and we are able to predict whether a precipitation reaction occurs if we can write a net ionic equation. In this video, we'll do some chemical calculations. In a dull replacement reaction, compound AB reacts with compound CD. Ion A combines with ion D to form one product. Ion C combines with ion B to form the second product. In a precipitation reaction, one of those products is insoluble in water. In a precipitation reaction, we want to be able to use and apply a solubility rules table. Here is a solubility rules table. Stop the video, take a picture of this table, and refer to this table when we're doing these precipitation reactions. In a dull replacement reaction, compound AB reacts with compound CD. A combines with D to form one product, C combines with B to form the second product. For this reaction, and the products are, and the balanced chemical equation, the coefficients are. We did this reaction on paper, but does this reaction really occur? We can predict that this reaction occurs if we can write a net ionic equation. A net ionic equation tells us what's happening in solution. Some compounds will break up into ions, others will not. To write a net ionic equation, we want to be able to classify each compound by its compound type, so stop the video and review these rules. Going back to that equation to make lime for fertilizer, the compounds that are soluble are, we want to break up those soluble compounds into ions. Note how we carry the coefficients in sodium hydroxide and sodium nitrate, and how the subscript in calcium nitrate becomes a coefficient. Compare the reactant side to the product side in our ionic equation. Note that there's two sodium ions on each side, so we can get rid of those, and there's two nitrates on each side, so we can get rid of those too. The sodium ion and nitrate ions do not participate in the reaction. Those are spectator ions. What's left are the ions directly involved in this reaction. We can write a net ionic equation, therefore we predict that this reaction does occur. Let's practice doing a chemical calculation, so stop the video and answer this question. And the answer is, here's how we got the answer. This is our molar mass conversion factor. This is the molar ratio based on the coefficient balanced chemical equation. And this is the molar mass of sodium hydroxide. Practice makes perfect, so to make 1 gram of calcium hydroxide, stop the video and answer this question. And the answer is, and here's how we got the answer. Check the molar masses and the mole ratios. We can check our answer by seeing if the conservation of mass is obeyed. It turns out that 2.3 grams of sodium nitrate is produced. So the masses of reactants are, and the masses of products are, and conservation of mass is obeyed. Let's predict whether this reaction occurs. Stop the video and write a molecular equation and net ionic equation. And the answer is yes, this reaction does occur and is used to test for the amount of sodium in a water sample. So here's what's happening. Let's check solubility. Here is our ionic equation. Are there any spectator ions? So sodium ion and nitrate ions are the spectator ions, and here's what's happening to form silver chloride precipitate. Let's do a practice problem involving this reaction. Stop the video, read the problem statement, and answer these questions. And the answers are, the solid is the precipitate that formed. We've got to do a few conversions to calculate the mass of sodium in the water sample. For the last question, there's 0.040 grams of sodium in a 10 mil water sample. So in 240 mils, there's 960 milligrams of sodium, so we would not get the RDA of sodium from drinking 1 cup of this water. In the test for sodium in water, it's best to use the exact amount of silver nitrate reactant that reacts with all of the NaCl. That reduces the amount of waste. But to make sure all of the NaCl reacts, an excess of silver nitrate is added. Let's apply this idea of limiting an excess reactants to a biology example. We know this is how a body is made, so stop the video and answer this question. And the answer is, this row shows the amount of reactants that we have. Based on the coefficients in our balanced chemical equation and the molar ratio, this is the amount of reactants that react. The initial amount minus the amount that reacts gives us how much is left over. So arms are the limiting reactant. Using the amount of any reactant that reacts and mole ratios, we can calculate the number of bodies produced. The other way to do this is to remember the limiting reactant limits the amount of product produced. So start with the initial amount of each reactant and calculate the amount of product formed. ARMS produces the smallest amount of product, so that must be the limiting reactant. Rather than starting with the number of body parts or moles, usually we start with the mass of each reactant. Starting with 500 grams of each reactant and given the molar mass of each body part, stop the video and answer this question. And the answer is, here's how we got that theoretical yield. So 500 grams of A produces 0.069 moles of bodies. Here's our molar mass, and this is our mole ratio. The other reactants produce, torsos produce the smallest amount of bodies, so that's the limiting reactant. Then do a moles to mass conversion. Remember, you've done these conversions before. The only difference is the reaction, the mole ratios, and molar mass. So let's put it all together. Stop the video, predict the product of this reaction, and do this calculation. And the answer is, we have a double replacement reaction, and here are the products. The equation is balanced. Here are the mole ratios. We want to determine the limiting reactant, so let's calculate the moles of each reactant. We're given 100 grams of TSP, sodium phosphate, so use this formula to calculate the moles. We have 100 milliliters, 1 molar magnesium sulfate solution, so use this formula to calculate the moles. Which reactant limits the amount of sodium sulfate produced? Magnesium sulfate limits the amount of sodium sulfate produced. Now we can use this formula to calculate the mass of sodium sulfate produced. Another type of double replacement reaction is when we add something to dissolve a precipitate. Tooth enamel is the hardest substance in our body. This compound contains three ions. Hydroxide is a base, so it turns out that this part of tooth enamel reacts with the acid and acidic foods to dissolve the tooth enamel. Fluoride reacts with tooth enamel in a replacement reaction. Stop the video and determine the products of this reaction. And the answer is, fluoride replaces hydroxide to form fluorapatite. It only takes a tiny amount of fluoride, about one part per million, to prevent cavities. Look up the Colorado brown stain if you're interested. They call this compound the cavity slayer. The isotope strontium-89 is radioactive and is the product of a nuclear fission reaction. If your cows and milk have been irradiated with strontium-89, it can be removed with this nanoparticle. Stop the video and predict the products of this replacement reaction. And the answer is, good job. The isotope strontium-90 is another radioactive isotope. Stop the video and answer this question. And the answer is, stay away from atom bomb tests.